Modern infantry fighting vehicles are no longer just armored transports. They're battlefield predators designed to fight alongside tanks, support frontline troops, and dominate complex combat environments. Armed with autocannons, anti-tank missiles, and advanced sensor suites, today's IFVs are faster, deadlier, and smarter than ever before. Whether charging through open terrain or maneuvering through tight urban streets, these machines bring the firepower of a small platoon, the protection of a tank's skin, and the intelligence of a high-tech command post. In an era where mobility, firepower, and survivability define success, modern IFVs have become the steel backbone of mechanized warfare. Let's take a closer look at some of the most formidable IFVs on today's battlefield. Explosions rip through the battlefield as a sleek, heavily armored vehicle charges forward, its turret scanning for threats, its cannon poised to strike. This is the Puma infantry fighting vehicle, Germany's frontline war machine built to dominate modern combat with raw power, speed, and precision. Engineered for high threat environments, the Puma blends survivability, mobility, and firepower into a single platform capable of keeping pace with tanks while delivering infantry into the heart of the fight. It's not just a troop carrier, it's a battlefield predator. Developed by Project System Management, a joint venture between Krauss, Maffei, Wegmann, and Rheinmetall, the Puma was designed to replace Germany's Cold War-era Marder IFVs and bring the Bundeswehr into a new era of mechanized warfare. Every inch of this vehicle reflects German engineering focused on battlefield adaptability and crew protection. The Puma's armor is modular and scalable, allowing it to adapt to different threat environments. In its basic configuration, the vehicle weighs around 69,200 pounds, offering protection against machine gun fire and artillery fragments. With additional armor kits, its weight increases to approximately 95,000 pounds, enabling it to resist 30mm cannon fire and shaped charge attacks. The vehicle also boasts underbelly protection against mines and IEDs, safeguarding its three-person crew and up to six infantry soldiers on board. To augment its defensive capabilities, the Puma IFV received reactive armor modules supplied by Dynamit Noble Defense. These modules offer additional protection against a range of threats, including rocket-propelled grenades and kinetic energy projectiles. The vehicle's existing hard-kill active protection system, designed to intercept incoming projectiles, was also maintained, ensuring comprehensive defense mechanisms. Its firepower centers around the Mark 30 2 ABM 30mm automatic cannon, capable of firing 200 rounds per minute and engaging targets up to 9,800 feet away. The MG4 is the secondary armament mounted on Germany's Puma infantry fighting vehicle, serving as a reliable and responsive tool for engaging enemy infantry and soft targets. A notable advancement for the Puma IFV was the integration of the multi-role capable light missile system, the Bundeswehr's designation for the Spike LR anti-tank guided missile. This addition significantly improved the vehicle's capability to engage and neutralize armored threats at extended ranges. Furthermore, the Puma was equipped with a turret-independent secondary weapon system, providing enhanced flexibility in various combat scenarios. Under the hood, a 1,087-horsepower diesel engine propels the Puma to speeds of up to 45 miles per hour, allowing it to maneuver quickly across open ground or urban environments. Its advanced suspension system ensures a stable ride, reducing crew fatigue and maintaining combat effectiveness across rough terrain. Inside, the Puma offers more than just armor and firepower. It provides advanced battlefield awareness. A full suite of high-resolution day and thermal imaging sensors offers 360-degree coverage, enabling the crew to detect threats in any conditions. NBC, or Nuclear Biological and Chemical Protection, air conditioning and an ergonomic interior complete a package designed for high-performance warfare. The Puma S1 variant was outfitted with a new UAV detector capable of identifying, classifying, and locating up to 9 drones simultaneously. This system enhances the vehicle's situational awareness and counter-unmanned aerial system capabilities. Additionally, the integration of high-resolution day and night vision camera systems for the driver and mounted infantry squad, along with improved optronics for the gunner and commander, further improved target acquisition and battlefield awareness. With over 400 vehicles ordered and an ongoing modernization program upgrading early units to the latest S1 configuration, the Puma is set to remain the backbone of Germany's mechanized infantry for years to come. Combining cutting-edge technology, firepower, and protection, the Puma IFV isn't just a response to modern threats, it's a statement of battlefield dominance. While the Puma showcases Germany's approach to cutting-edge infantry fighting vehicles with a focus on protection and modularity, Sweden's CV90 takes a different path, prioritizing battlefield adaptability, tactical speed, and combat-proven versatility across a range of environments. The origin of the CV90, also known as the Combat Vehicle 90, can be traced back to the mid-1980s in Sweden. This versatile family of armored vehicles was born out of a necessity for high-performance combat machines during the Cold War. The Swedish Army sought vehicles offering high mobility, anti-tank capabilities, and air defense. They required vehicles with enhanced survivability and robust protection, all of which the CV90 series fulfills. The CV90-40C, a collaboration between Swedish industrial giants Bofors and Hägglunds, exhibits top-tier specifications. Bofors was responsible for developing the turret, armor, and final assembly, while Hägglunds contributed its expertise in chassis and armored hull creation. Speaking of its protection capabilities, the CV90 features an all-welded steel armor hull. This robust shell allows it to withstand 14.5mm armor-piercing rounds, and later versions have reportedly stood against 30mm APF SDSs. Additional modular armor can be fitted, significantly enhancing protection against threats such as improvised explosive devices, explosively formed penetrators, and larger 30mm armor-piercing rounds. Cage armor can also be added to safeguard against tandem charge and shaped charge warheads. The vehicle's design optimizes utility and defense. It houses a troop compartment at the rear, accessed through a large door equipped with a vision block and a central firing port. Depending on the variant, it can carry between 6 and 8 soldiers. Despite modifications that added bulk and weight, the vehicle's weight stands at 30.42 tons. The CV90-40C, which will serve in Ukraine, has remarkable mobility capabilities. It has a 550-horsepower Swedish-made Scania DI-14 V8 diesel engine that drives a fully automatic Perkins Engines Company X305N transmission. This configuration allows the vehicle to reach a maximum speed of 43.5 miles per hour and a maximum range of 198.8 miles. This level of mobility, coupled with its excellent performance in cold conditions and snowy, marshy terrains, renders it a powerful asset on various front lines. However, it's in combat that the CV90-40C truly shines. Its primary armament is a 40mm Bofors Defense 4070B cannon, capable of engaging ground targets up to 1.24 miles. This gun can target a hovering helicopter from 2.48 miles. The gunner or commander can control this weapon, selecting single shots or automatic firing with a cyclic rate of 300 rounds per minute. Additionally, the CV90 features a 7.62mm M39 coaxial machine gun mounted on the left side of the main armament, and it boasts three smoke grenade discharges on each side of the turret. Despite lacking anti-tank missiles, its Bofors gun makes this IFV a formidable adversary against opposing tanks. Another noteworthy feature of the CV90 is the two Bofors Liron 71mm mortar tubes fitted at the turret rear. They can fire illuminating bombs to a maximum range of about 1 mile, which proves immensely useful during nighttime operations or in areas with low visibility. The CV90-40C is a high-performance, multi-role combat machine, meticulously engineered to endure in challenging conditions and terrains, demonstrating exceptional protection, mobility, and firepower. From its origin during the Cold War to its successful deployment in Afghanistan and now in Ukraine, the CV90 series embodies a potent mix of versatility and ruggedness. Now, it's time to talk about a warrior worthy of its name. Named after the illustrious American hero, General Omar Bradley, the M2 Bradley IFV has consistently been an overachiever. This remarkable armored warhorse has been faithfully transporting US troops across battlefields, offering them robust fire support and occasionally outperforming its class by taking down main battle tanks, as seen in Iraq and recently in Ukraine. Though a fierce fighter at its core, the M2 Bradley's primary role remains safeguarding soldiers' lives. As recent conflicts in Ukraine have demonstrated, it is unparalleled in fulfilling this duty. Despite being targeted frequently, the Ukrainian fleet of M2 A2ODS infantry fighting vehicles has shown remarkable resilience against Russian assaults, avoiding substantial crew fatalities. The US Army's Bradley Infantry Vehicle is a full-tracked, medium-armored vehicle capable of providing cross-country mobility and protection to mechanized units. These vehicles were meant to serve as both an armored personnel carrier and a tank killer. The M2 Bradley IFV, a formidable armored fortress on tracks, embodies both agility and defense in its design. Measuring approximately 21.5 feet in length and 11.8 feet in width, it presents a robust yet maneuverable profile on the battlefield. Its primary armor is constructed from high-strength welded aluminum, fortified further with spaced laminate belts and reactive armor tiles to withstand the onslaught of enemy fire. The thickness of the armor, which incorporates classified composite materials, offers an optimized balance between protection and weight, safeguarding against a variety of anti-armor threats. The main armament is an ATK ammunition systems, formerly Boeing Ordnance, 25mm M242 Bushmaster chain gun. The M242 has a single barrel with an integrated dual feed mechanism and remote feed selection. The IFV's arsenal also includes a 7.62 coaxial machine gun, armor-piercing, sub-caliber, and high-explosive ammunition. Besides, Bradley has a TOW ATGM launcher. Infantry can fight from inside the vehicle by using modified M16 rifles mounted in firing ports, although these ports were removed from A4 version onward. Among the unique features of the Bradley is its independent viewer that allows commanders to scan for targets and maintain situational awareness. The weight of the M2 A2ODS SA amounts to 37.7 tons. The vehicle is driven by a 600 horsepower engine. With a top speed of 38 miles per hour, the vehicle can accommodate a crew of 3 and up to 7 squad members. M2 Bradley possesses sufficient cross-country mobility to keep up with the M1 Abrams main battle tank, medium and long-range firepower, and is adequately armored to protect the crew from artillery and small arms threats. This concludes our episode on the modern infantry fighting vehicles. So, what do you think about these remarkable weapon systems? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see one of the vehicles mentioned in this video up close, or better yet, operated one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.